Hey my friend, Sam Haymart for Test Driven TV. Recently I got the chance to test drive the all-new redesigned 2018 Kia Rio, their subcompact sedan. What I think? Coming right up. The 2018 Kia Rio is the most affordable model in the brand's showroom, and for this year is all new from the standpoint of design inside and out, has more features than ever to compare to the peers from Toyota, Nissan, Honda, and others. In its redesign, the Kia Rio grows slightly, about a half inch in length and wheelbase. And while it grows slightly wider too, the overall height is slightly lower. All of this gives it that classic longer, lower, wider profile theme that we see every decade or so in car design. More European in its styling, the new Rio is actually perhaps more conservative and formal in its details, with the Kia Tiger Nose grille and headlamps being more upright and less severe in their presentation than before. The surfaces are smoother with less sharpness and contour lines, which Kia says is added sophistication. At the rear, this is evident in a more formal upright roofline and shorter overhangs. In spite of its slight growth, the Rio remains compact, which is why even its largest 15-inch wheels look perfectly proportionate to the rest of the car. A big upgrade from the last generation is the interior, which takes on a design more akin to the upscale models we've seen, like the new Stinger. While this is no luxury sports sedan, the materials and overall look is much elevated from before. The seats are comfortable with a sturdy fabric. The switchgear is above class in its quality and feel, and the level of standard amenities beats many of its peers in this price class. Storage too is plentiful, with easy livability if you bring lots of devices along for the ride. I like the display audio system here, which offers up a lot more functionality and feature content than systems in similarly priced competitors. You have Apple CarPlay and Android Auto among a vast list of features. Graphics are good and the menus are well laid out, though it does force the home screen every time you start the car instead of staying where you left it. Powering the Kia Rio is a familiar 1.6-liter direct-injected 4-cylinder engine with a few tuning changes that net it better fuel economy than before. With the 6-speed automatic transmission I tested, I was impressed with the 36 mpg I achieved in a week of city driving. This is good considering the EPA combined rating is only 32. It has plenty of pep with 130 horsepower in the gearing of its transmission. Most notable is the refinement level here that was a pleasant surprise in addition to the traditional shifting feel unlike the CVT's most competitors force upon you. Handling also surprised me in its level of refinement and overall feel. The suspension is basic with struts up front and a torsion beam at the rear, but it's impressive in the sense of quality and confidence that it has over speed humps, freeway tar strips, and potholes. Even taking corners in town at above average speeds, it manages to please. If there's any complaint here, it's that the new for 2018 autonomous emergency braking system is a bit overly concerned and parental, hitting the brakes and panicking even when it really isn't warranted. More than once, it kicked in and sent my food or papers flying to the floor unexpectedly. Not fun. These are growing pains for new technologies we will surely talk about more in time. In the large picture, I came away very impressed with the new Kia Rio. It feels far more substantial in terms of quality and content than most anything you can compare it to. And priced at $19,728 well-equipped, it represents likely one of the best values in class. Obviously, I was pretty impressed with this little guy. A very well-built car, feels solid for its price, and I do think is definitely worth a look if you're looking at Nissan Versa, Honda Fit, Toyota Yaris. Even the Hyundai Accent, which I'll point out is mechanically identical to this car, even though its styling and packaging completely different, but all the same goodness going on when it comes to living with it every day. Anyway, click right here, see our latest test drive, or click right here, subscribe to our YouTube channel. Either way, I'll always tell you what I think.